easy cooking. Here I'm going to show you a very popular North Indian dish or a recipe which mostly South Indians love to eat but is very lazy to make. So here I'm going to show you a twist of that recipe and make it much more easier for you all to cook. So I'm going to prepare aloo paratha for all of you. Without much delay, let me show you a twist of aloo paratha, how to make it jhatpat. So I will show you what I have to do for the jhatpat aloo paratha. Mainly for aloo paratha, what we do is we boil the potatoes and mash it and stuff in the rotis. So here I'm going to show you with a twist. What we do, ingredients, please check my description box. What are the quantity and the proper ingredients? So let me take you and show you immediately how do I do. I have taken one big onion, roughly chop in the mixer. This is two tomatoes, roughly chopped. This is one green chili, one chunk of ginger and 4-5 cloves of garlic. This is all a twist to my recipe. I'm not adding this tomato right now into the jar because let me just grind it and again add it to it. Yes, I'm going to add the rest of the tomato. Just wanted to give some space to it, that's why. Two tomatoes roughly chopped I have taken. So this is, I've just grinded it and kept it ready. Now what we do, I've taken here four potatoes. We will grate it simply like this and keep it. Now we have grated the potatoes, all the four potatoes and kept. Now let's add it to the vessel where we are going to make the dough, the paratha dough. Okay, the potatoes have already got water content, so we don't need much water for this aloo paratha. Here is a grinded masala, chutney we can say, a kind of chutney. Tomatoes, we have added tomatoes, garlic, ginger and green chili. Here we go. Now to this we add, what is this? Ajwain or carom seeds, or in Malayalam we call aimodagam. Always when you add ajwain, just give a slight rub and then put so that the whole flavor goes in it. 1 teaspoon of ajwain I have put. Now this is 1 teaspoon of fennel seeds or saumph. Saumph, and this is 1 teaspoon of jeera. We put that as well. And this is coriander leaf finely chopped. To this we add spice accordingly. I have taken 1 teaspoon of chili powder. I have already put green chilies and ginger to it. So chili powder goes in it. Now we can add coriander powder, 1 teaspoon, and little of turmeric powder. Okay, now to this we just mix all the ingredients very well like this so that everything goes in it. And one important ingredient we have forgotten, what is it? Salt. Yes, we need to add salt. So add salt to it. And now to this we add little by little atta. Atta, there is no quantity, the wheat flour. Till the time it binds, we will keep adding slowly. So in my description box, I will be letting you know how many parathas we can make with this much quantity of ingredients. So don't forget to check my description box. Slowly we add wheat flour. No need to add water at all because potatoes release water, and we have added tomato paste as well. So now we have made the dough almost like chapati dough or paratha dough. So at this stage, let's add a kind of 1 tablespoon of oil to it. The best thing of this recipe is that you don't have to rest the dough for a long time. If you rest it, more water content may release because of the potatoes. The raw potatoes and tomatoes. So you can just make it and you can prepare it immediately. So I'll show you soon. Yeah, this dough is ready to prepare aloo paratha. Just kept a tawa. Let's lit the gas and start to make the parathas. So this is our dough. We need to take the dry atta as well. Here we take a small bowl and just take the sukka atta and slowly let us make a shape. Those who are not used to make parathas, do try this method. If you practice for a few times, definitely you will be able to make it. I guarantee you, for the beginners, it's not a big task. Few times you make parathas and definitely it's going to turn out to be a great success. So I want everybody to try this recipe of aloo paratha. You don't have to go and buy it from outside. So this is done. So when the tawa is hot, let's put this paratha to it. And either we can use oil or butter, whichever is your preference, but I prefer butter in my parathas. So I add butter on the sides. Let the reverse side of it get cooked. Just keep stirring this way. Let's flip it. To cook well, the potatoes are raw, so it will take little time to cook. We'll keep the flame on low to medium. Now, parathas are getting cooked. Let's flip it again. We have added enough of butter at the time of serving as well. You can add little bit of butter. These parathas are very crispy and yummy too. So do try and do comment how you like this easy recipe. So this Mama, is almost ready. Yes, baby.
Mama, this aroma is very nice. I loved it.
Yes, we are going to eat it. Yeah. You can serve it along with pickle or curd, whatever is your preference. Yes, here is our second paratha getting ready to cook. You don't want to make it very thin. You can just make it thick parathas also. Yes, here is the second one. As I said, just add butter on sides. If you prefer oil, you can put oil. But for parathas, butter tastes the best. So our parathas are ready. So here we go. This is the jhatpat cooking of aloo paratha in a new variations. I hope all of you really like it.
Oh, Mama, this is one of my favorite parathas.
Yes, so all of you should try my kid's favorite paratha. Do check the description box. I have written all the ingredients with the quantity. And if you are not subscribed till now, don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon so that you get notification of my new recipes. Till then, bye-bye. See you.